Hey everyone, and welcome back to Gearblox. I am going to continue work on the Jeep Bike SUV. Last episode, I fixed some of the bits that were kind of colliding, like the steering. I think it might still hit a little bit, but I'm not sure. And then the links and track bars needed a little bit of adjusting. So I did that. I still need to do some work on the steering, because it's a bit of a pain in the butt. Because, you know, I didn't actually turn, it just kind of turned on its own. What else? I would like to get the hood and grill on today, and I would also like to get some sway bars on it. So, I'm going to actually put the quote-unquote differential locks on first. I should also put a cross member in the back. So I'm going to put a cross member across first really quick. Steel. Beam. Like so. And then I will lock it to there and not to the body. And then I should put another one across the back, but I'm going to see where the sway bar ends up being before I put another cross member on the back. I should also add another cross member to the middle really quick while I'm at it. Make sure this is all recording properly. Yep, okay. Okay, lock that into place. I will likely, at some point, go through and figure out a way to make the chassis not hang down so low. Because that does really bother me. But, at the moment, there's nothing I can do about it. Okay, so we have a bit more quote-unquote structural support. Not like it's really needed in this, but whatever. Now, for the differential lock, it doesn't exactly lock the differential together because I use a clutch gear for it. Yeah, I use a clutch gear, so it does have a little bit of slip, but it works. If I were to use a piston and two gears that kind of slide back and forth, it would properly lock the differential. But, oh well. There, and then that one goes there. That's rotate. There we go, okay. So now whenever this clutch is enabled, it forces this wheel to spin the same as the ring gear is, which also in turn just ends up locking the rest of it. So I will quickly do this on the front as well. Did I lock all of that in place? No, I did not. Okay. Time to do this side. My nose and stuff is still all stuffy like usual, so hopefully I'm not like clearing my throat and stuff a whole ton, but and then I can make some, like, extra supports and stuff so it's a little better at some point. Sway bars. I'm also going to make them disconnecting sway bars. Or at least on the front I will. So I'm going to do that one first. And since it's the one that I'm going to have the most space issues with. Because I have no idea where I'm going to put it on this. To this truck here. Where did I put them? In between the links. I can probably do that with this as well. Yeah, I'll just do that with this as well. So I need just a simple block to go in right here. Oops. Oops. Stop it. Okay, that. Let me bring it over to this side. So. Lock it in place. And then I'm going to grab the ball because I like to have the sway bar links as the sockets and then the other ends as the balls. It just, in my opinion, works best that way. Kind of nice how the CV joints have a little bit of play in them, allowing us to make sway bars out of them. And this should work. Should. It's down. Put a socket on top. Lock that into place. And then hopefully it doesn't have to be too long for this pin or ball wasn't there. I could put it through there, but it looks like I'm going to have to go through here, which makes measuring easy. It's just the full length of this thing, but it gives the sway bar itself a little less effectiveness. How do you do this side really quick? Now I can use pull and axle. Ooh, maybe not. This knees. I'm going to nudge that down to there and use an angle 0 for this end. I'll do the same for this side. And then I can use the outer wherever it is. Here. And stick it in there. Make it rotate through the chassis, and then that is that. Cool. And hopefully I have enough space to do what I'm wanting to do. I did this on the truck that I was kind of testing things with over there, and it works. So, we'll see. Now I need to bring this end through. And I normally use 2 CV joints for the sway bars, but with this design, there's a couple gears that make it have a little bit more play in it. So, I'm only going to use 1. I should also make sure this doesn't flop around. I'll just go like this for now. This should be good enough just to hold it from flopping around a little bit. Come on. There we go. And then if I need to change this, I will. I'll likely need to change it for the, so I can put the piston on it, but I need the little spur gears. Oops. Ooh, there we go. And then a piston to move another set of spur gears, which will likely go here. But the motor's kind of getting in the way. So I'll probably put it on this side. I'm going to quickly get this piece lined up with a hole and an axle thingy on it so that I can figure out where the piston needs to go. There's probably a much easier way to do this too, but this is just how I do it. So, this part are obviously separate, but this bar here connects them, making it work as one. And then a piston moves this over, therefore allowing these to be separate. Okay, where do I want the piston though? Small linear actuator. Because if I put it here, this will likely work best. Yeah, that'll work perfectly. Do like so. And just lock all of this into place. Let that rotate. Lock all of this into place. And I'm going to move. I'm going to move this holder thingy over to the other side. Excuse me. There we go. A little bit better. And this should work just fine. Okay. So there's the front sway bar. I will now do the rear sway bar. I have a little bit less space that I can use for this one, but it should be fine. Where did I do it on the back of this? Really quick. To clean the wheel and the shocks. Which might get in the way of articulation, but it shouldn't too much. And it's just the same thing as the front, but on the back. I should go through and make this all proper steel instead of some of it still being galvanized. Okay. Now we use socket. Come up to the chassis, bring this down by one. And then this socket facing backwards. Was just thinking if I moved it to the inside, it would keep a better like center of gravity and might give me a bit more space for other things. But with the way the chassis is at the moment, that's not going to work. And typically, it goes this way anyways. Oh, I'm gonna have perfect room. Oops, that's not what I wanted to do. Okay, I can lock all of this into place. And then use an angle 0 again. With same excellent stuff before. Call that into place. Let that rotate. Ooh, inner. So bring it almost all the way over. And there we go. Oops, that's the wrong piece. Actually, if I do use this, it'll allow me to have less total parts. I think I'll do that. I'll try that. And then I need holder. I can put the piston on the inside, so I'm going to put the holder on the outside. Alrighty. That should be most of it done. Put on the gears on this part, lock those into place, and then measure out this again. Gears on there. Little bar that the piston goes on, make sure those can rotate. Put the piston on. I would like to have the piston like not hanging so far under everything, but it's fine. There we go. Oops. We now have unlocking sway bars. Have them active for just normal driving, and then when we're crawling, we can disable them and let them just kind of flex however they want. And the wheel shouldn't bind with it too bad if it does. Like I said, the truck that I was kind of testing this on worked fine, so I'm hoping this will work fine too. Now, I need to figure out the grill. Could probably bring this in by one more, but I'm not all that worried about it. The grill on a normal Jeep just kind of sits on top of the frame. I need to switch to plastic. As I'm doing all the body in plastic for now, I can always change it later if I want to. So I'm gonna go like this for now. Use a sloped beam. I can never get these to rotate the way I want them to. There we go. And stick that there. Yeah, that looks okay, I guess. Looks a little wide, but whatever. I can always adjust things after. lock this all together. And then I'm hoping I might have to leave a little cutout in the hood for the motor. But then again, could also make a little hood scoop kind of thing that acts like it's cooling for the motor. I would also like to put on an RPM thingy onto the motor, because I like being able to see how fast the motor is spinning and then my overall speed and stuff. But that can wait till after. I might bring this down because the hood needs to have a bit of a slope in it, which might be a little difficult. So I also need a way to make it open and close, so I need to make a simple hinge. Let's grab the servo. Nope, I want the small one. And I'm going to put it here. Or here. I should probably put it down here. I'll put it here for now. And then we grab a bit of an axle. And then a sloped beam. Ooh, hold on. A rounded beam. And then a sloped beam on top of that, so that it can properly rotate against the firewall. Okay. That's a bit higher than I wanted the hood to be. But I can likely do a little bit of adjusting. We'll see. So I want a plate here. I might need to use an L plate somewhere so that I can attach the sides to it. I believe that's even. And then if the hood is this high, I can get away with having it go over the motor. But I don't want it up this high. So instead of this, I'm going to just use this. And then I can put a little plate on top of it. So. And that should work. Maybe if I extend this out a little bit. Like so. All right. Now that should be the height where I want it to be. And it is. A little long. But I'm still trying to figure out how I'm going to get this piece on. So, if I lift this up, I wish I could crouch. That'd be so helpful. Move this over and then use a little plate right here. I should be able to put an L plate on top of that. That will allow me to put on a sloped piece, which it will. I just need to move this back a bit. Lock that together, move that back. Okay. And then if I put on just another one of these, so that's the wrong way. Really? I'm holding this side. Why would it attach that side when I'm holding this side? That makes no sense to me. Really? Why? Okay. Okay, this game can be such a pain in the butt sometimes. There we go. I'm gonna leave. Interesting. Okay, so I will just use another plate then, I guess. Can always go through and change stuff after. Okay. So that's kind of that. And then I can just use a couple plates to fill in the rest of it. This needs to not be locked to anything, so I can do the same on this other side. Keep that. There. Oops. I just. Yep. This should be. Oh, it's being such a pain in the butt. If I remove this temporarily, and then this, it will have no choice but to connect where I want it to. Theoretically. Really? Come on. This is actually really starting to piss me off. That's the plate. Why is it doing this? I don't get it. I don't get why this isn't cooperating. So I'll just stick these pieces back on for now. That should also be, whatever. If I continue with the hood, I might be able to mount that in a different spot, like up here. So, I will abandon this part of the idea for the moment. If I need to, I can just copy it and mirror it. I'm going to make sure this is the same width. It looks like it is. And I will bring the hood to the front. So I need two plates. Just little bitty ones that I can stick on here. But I can add some more plates to it. So I should probably be doing this a little bit differently, but we'll see. Because I want the proper angle to the hood. I just bring that up to there. I can likely mount this up here instead. I do need to make it one more narrower, though. It's a little bit of a pain in the butt. This will work. I will make it work. Then this should go there, like so. But now I've got all this area to fill in. So if I bring this just all the way over to there, I can probably get a wedge or like an angled piece to fit in there. So if I move this back, I'll put this here, bring it across to there, like so. And I'm going to lock it into place. So it doesn't move. And then I should be able to mount this back piece to it from underneath. Ooh. Come on, let me. Pressing the right button would help. Okay. And then I need another one off to the side. Ready. This can now go on here. I could also do it more of a cowl induction, but I think a roof or a hood scoop would funnel air into onto the motor better. Okay, hopefully I can put a wedge on here. Oops. I likely can. I just need to make it one block narrower. But this one can actually come out all the way. Oops. Should be able to. And then this needs to be one narrower. Like so. I'll lock this back into place again. Stick this back on. And now this should fit. So. I won't be able to have it out all the way, but it gets the point across. I do also. Is that even attached to anything now? I'm just trying to figure out the grill because the grill kinda comes up a bit. But it doesn't need to be perfect. It really doesn't. I'm just trying to think a little bit. If I continue the other side of the hood really quick, I'm going to pull this off again really quick. That, and then I can work on the other side of the hood at the moment. So I need I can grab this, put it over here. It is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. One, two. There-ish. Yes, above the frame rail. Okay. That goes like that. And then this I will duplicate and put on like so. And it goes almost onto the motor like that. Lock those into place. And then duplicate this here. I'm just making sure this is all locked really quick. There should be, yep, one block gap, hinge, and then this gets flipped and put onto this side. I am over time for this video, but I want to get this done. And I tried to record Vice City Stories before this, but it was being really laggy for some reason, just a massive frame stutter every couple seconds. So now I need to figure out how I'm going to this. If I could use an L plate, and then it would allow me to kind of build up around it. So I will try that on this side really quick since it has less pieces. So if I grab an L plate and angle it this way, resize it to that. Stick it on there. Come on, cooperate. Oh, it's a little too long. There we go. That looks about right. Now, I should be able to put a wedge on the inside, but I need to make it a bit narrower. Still. Oops, it is still locked. There we go. Right, bring it over by one, and then like so. But I also need to figure out a top for it. And the only thing that I could really use for that is a sloped plate. So I'm going to pull that off for a moment. And I'm going to grab the sloped plate and stick that on there. Which it's not happy about. Go. And I could just do that. It doesn't look the greatest, but it'll work. If I stick this back onto here, right there, I believe, the end of there, this on there, that should work out evenly. I'll have to bring it up a tiny bit more just because of how it is, because of this annoying little piece here. But it works. There's an ugly big bulge in the hood, but then again, there's also a grill that will allow air through it. So instead of that, I'm going to just, I'm going to put a hole in the cowl that will allow the quote unquote air out. And then this will just kind of have a hole in it. So, scrap that idea. That back on there. And then, do, 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 do. For some reason, every time I say "and then," I think of the drive-through person from "Dude, Where's My Car?" That is such a dumb movie. It's funny, and like early 2000s humor, it's a good movie and funny, but nowadays it's just so dumb. If you happen to have seen that movie, let me know. What's your favorite part in it? Is it the drive-through person? Is it, the scene with the blind kid? If you've seen the movie, that'll make sense. If you haven't, that'll sound really bad, but is it that part? What's your favorite part? I need to still put another plate on it to cover up that. I don't know, would it be kind of cool having the motor stick through? I hate saying motor. Like, yes, it's electric, but I'm so used to saying engine that my brain wants to say engine and not motor. Motor just sounds weird, but it's a motor, not an engine, so. There we go. Now I need to figure out the grill somehow. And then putting the, the little last cowl bit on here shouldn't be too hard. So, the grill with the lights and stuff. How am I going to mount all of that? Because this might need to come out by one more so that I can mount the fender on it. So, I'm going to pull that out really quick. And then put this piece onto here, if it would let me. Well, not the fender, but the side of the hood. That's actually sticking out too far. So, I will have to make the hood a little bit narrower. This part a little narrower, and this part wider, which isn't gonna work. I can just put a little piece in there that also mounts onto that. So, and this should now. That should be connected. Oh, okay. That makes sense. Lift that up. Put this one block forwards from where it was. Lock it into place. Lift this back down. Or drop it back down, whatever. This on. Lift it back up. One thing I do like about scrap a bit more is using the lift to move and build things is quite a bit easier. See, now I need to put a. There. Good. Now I can just use this little piece to fill out this gap. So, there we go. There's that side of the hood. See that having it squared off on the top doesn't look the greatest, but whatever, I guess. I will now adjust this side. This also needs to be longer. Like so. Lock all of this again. So it doesn't decide to run away whenever I move something. I don't need these out anymore. Do need to. That's why we lock things. That's also not in the proper spot. Oopsies. This needs to go there. But on the bottom. Really? Really? Come on. Anything else not wanting to cooperate? This goes there and stretches to there, I believe. I didn't get a whole lot done in this video. I probably could have done more if I focused on a couple smaller things, but I want to get the body done, and I'm not that great at doing bodies, so. Like, the best vehicle body I've done in this so far is probably my mini truck thingy. And even that's not that great. It's that one right there. Just a little off topic for a moment, but this is probably the best body I've done so far. And even the bed is just a basic boxy bed. But either way. The back windows look way too big. I should probably make them a bit smaller, but whatever. Now, I need to simply just duplicate all of this stuff. Ooh, it's too wide. Oh, it's because I made this part too long, I think. There we go. That makes sense. And this goes on top of that with this dingy on it. And then this dingy on there. Now, when I lower this down, I should be able to just stick this in place. So. And there we go. The hood is basically done. I guess I could just bring a beam across like this. It doesn't look the greatest. This part I will lock to the chassis because it's kind of separate from the rest of the body and just kind of does its own thing. But that needs to not be attached to that. But it's still attached to something that it shouldn't be. Oh, right here. This turn now? No. Where is it stuck still? I don't know. I can. Really? Didn't I just disable that? Okay, now it can rotate. So yeah, it doesn't look the greatest, but at least it's got a little bit of shape to it. Now I need to figure out the lights. I should also Put the other hood hinge on. But I'm not super worried about it. I'll figure out the cowl and whatnot in the next episode. I'm just gonna throw some lights on it really quick. I will likely have some kind of light bar across the top, and then another light bar of, or like, the round lights or something, but I should go with something like this for the main lights. That's a little narrow for my liking, but that's okay, I guess. I'll lock that into place. And then I can. I wonder, will this one fit here? No, it will not. And it won't fit on the bottom either. Like right underneath it. So I'm going to take the one by one and put it there. And that can be my turn signal. And then the other turn signal goes in the side of the fender. They should be round, but lack of, round bits in this doesn't look too bad. It's in my opinion, it doesn't look too bad. And then the chassis should come out one block further than the thingamajiggy, the grill. I'm also doing most of this off of memory, off of how my dad's Jeep looked and how little Jeep is. So with, limitations of the game itself, and then just not having seen an actual Jeep to this detail in quite some time, there are going to be bits that are not fully accurate. But that looks fine for now. And then at some point, I can bring the fenders out and so on. I do need to put the grill bars in though. I might just use axles for this. I don't like how they stick through the top. But ah, it was doing it for me. With the bar count in the grill, it's gonna end up looking a bit more like a Hummer, but ooh. A Hummer would be so easy to build in this. Maybe after the Jeep, I will do a Hummer. And then can I put something here? Just to kind of fill that in. I'll have to flip it. Awesome. Now there isn't just a big hole on the side. Same there, lock it into place, and it also kind of helps hold the lights in. Cool. I kind of like it. It could be a bit more rounded, like the top should be rounded with the hood coming over it, but this is good enough for now. As I get better at the game and building stuff in it, the creations will start to look better. I would like to was gonna say I'd like to put in a high beam, but I can use the secondary lights as high beams. Or I could. I'm gonna paint the lower ones orange really quick, just so I don't forget that those are the turn signals. I could put a light over here. That was the right one. Because a small one will fit there. Just nothing will fit there. So I could use like these as the normal lights, and then this as a high beam. And then I could use the extra lights as extras, but I will see when I get there. But yeah, that's probably it for today's video. I typically only record for half an hour each video, but this one's almost an hour now, so. In the next episode, I will probably finish off the main body, put the doors on, put the tailgate and glass on the back, finish off the dash and whatnot. I would like to push the windshield back more again, or move this bit forwards or something just so it's a bit more accurate. I'll probably just move the dash back a little bit more, or the windshield back more. But I could also probably just stick a clear wedge in there. Either way, I'll figure out something. Yeah. This will also have to probably end up being a bit smaller. Stuff to think about for next time. I'll probably, once I'm done recording, just kind of stare at this for a little while and figure out what I want to do. I'm also going to I'll quickly test this before I end. So I'm going to turn on number lock. That'll turn it off. That'll turn it back on. Front sway bar. Only seated. And then I'm going to try setting it to toggle. And then, I'm going to need so many lights inside for. Monitoring everything. Okay, that should work. And then I can set these to 7 and 8. Rear diff lock. Set this to 7 because you typically lock the rear end before the front. Toggle and seated. And then front, diff, oops, that's still diff lock. I'm not locking myself. Ooh, toggle seated, all the torque. Okay. There we go. For some reason. The sway bars. Oh, because they aren't turned on. There we go. That's the passenger seat. Now that doesn't look too bad. Now that I'm like actually looking at it and whatnot, it looks all right. So you can see the front sway bar is currently active. If I press one, disables, and then the rear end disables. Because it's using gears, it's gonna have a little bit of slop in it. Don't roll. It'll still be a little bit more sloppy and stuff than I'd like it to be, but it's better than how much body roll it did have. I'm actually quite surprised at how much torque this has with how much speed it has. It has a good balance. My other vehicles aren't nearly this good. I'm very happy with how this is turning out. So, There is still something kind of binding. I need to work on the arms and stuff a little bit. But if I back up to here, it might lift a wheel. Not quite. I should make a proper RTI ramp. I should also finally shorten the axles, but. Alright, if I go like this. Good time to kind of test the. Yeah, it just doesn't have the torque for it. Oh, putting it in four-wheel drive would help too, but. Yeah, it doesn't have the torque. Okay. I'm going to kind of flex on this thingy. Oh, the steering broke again. That's another thing I gotta look into is making the steering a bit stronger as it does weird stuff again. Okay, so I'm going to disable those. We can see it's flexing, but it could be a little bit better. The rear wheel is off the ground. If I press one, it'll disable the front end, and front should now flex a lot more. It should, but there is something. Ooh, I might need to make the links longer. Okay then. That was interesting. Try this again. Unfreezing it would help. So, I'm going to just disable that right away. And it should. Yeah, I need to definitely. Interesting. These links, the link going down to the axle definitely needs to be longer. I could drop it down, this part down more. I could move this part up. I could also make this longer. If I press one and four, how does this? Really? Yeah, you can see something here needs to be a lot longer to stop it from inverting. But, come on. Go up the. Really? But other than that, it seems to be working just fine. Like, the rear end is okay. I'll figure it out in the next episode. If I back up, what happens? Why is this being. Yeah, it's a little bound up now, so. Even the rear end is messed up now, so. Uh-oh. So, yeah. I'll figure that out in the next episode. As usual, if you have any questions or tips or tricks, feel free to let me know in the comments. Anything you want me to check out, let me know. I could use a little bit of help, just, I'll probably just make this longer, like a lot longer, and that should help. And then I could use a couple ideas for making the steering a bit stronger. Oops. I could make it hydraulic assist, which is what I'll likely end up doing. Just replace this with a ram. But yeah. We'll see you next episode. Either way, as usual, I hope you enjoyed, and thanks for watching.